Alright, hopefully it's gonna go well. Hello there, everybody! Alright, I'm gonna take off the... I'm gonna take off the fucking... we're experiencing technical beaners. Okay, alright, here's the link to the stream.
Alright.
Alright, there we go. I'm gonna actually let the intro play. Also, while the intro is playing, let's actually mute the microphone. I'm gonna start a new game. So, yeah, I'm gonna share the link to the stream during the cutscene. But here we go! Oh, yeah, I'm just gonna take that slot. Okay, there we go. Okay, you can mute your mic now. So, people, let's listen to the first cutscene.
I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that litter our planet? How did they harness Eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of Green Eco, one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Hey! Jack, old Green Stuff told us not to come here.
Continue your search for artifacts and Eco. If the locals possess precursor items, you know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps. Huh? Oh, stupid precursor junk. Eek! What is that dark ooze? It sure don't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time.
Where did they go? Why did they build this crud?
Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble! Stung. I told you we shouldn't have come here, and you listened! What? Okay. I'm fine.
Green tarnation, do you two want?
I was...
Don't tell me! Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around in the only place that I told you not to go. Misty Island.
That's right, and then...
And, Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark eco.
Look, old man, are you gonna keep yapping, or are you gonna help me out of this mess?
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied Dark Eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Karl Acheron, the Sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages. I would teleport you there, but I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while. The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it if you had a zoomer equipped with a heat shield. I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment. All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira, that might work. But where are a boy and a half going to get 20 power cells?
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wilds just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better go through the warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark gooey eco stuff, will we? Because I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there before I turn you both into ferns.
Alright, so right now I think I need to turn down like the volume of the game because it's kind of loud, but Victor and Vicky, you can unmute your mic now.
Yes, I've
already
done that.
Unmuted. I've been unmuted the whole time,
motherfucker. Alright, good. Yeah, I'm actually currently... I thought you said like something that you... some game that you reminded me of that you used to play, something about Kid Clitoris or whatever.
Kid Clitoris.
Yeah, Kid Clitoris. Victor's favorite game about clitorises. No, I'm just kidding. Alright? People, I'm just sharing the link of the stream to some peeps, to some perps, so that's why I'm not moving currently in the game. And I really hope that people are actually... is there any comments actually going on?
Hang on, let me
move. Yeah, quite a few. There's some from Cool Bro saying Jak and Daxter, FTW. And Sandra says, please group.
Well, Sandra, awesome. You don't have a microphone, so there's really no point.
This game was fun to play, says Andreas, I think.
Mm-hmm. What's the username?
Andreas or... Andres, I think. Andres.
Andres Orlando.
Oh, that's not Andreas. That's Andres, it's the other username.
Okay. CoolPro195 says, Mance has the PS2 game. And then Leon says, laugh my ass.
Mel. Musty Island.
Island. And he says, lots of people voted Crash, but this game won the vote.
The
amazing guy says, best platform ever.
Alright people, so we're right now starting our adventure of Jak and Daxter! I just really hope that there's not gonna be any cutscenes every fucking second. And yeah people, this is actually the second time or third time I'm streaming this. The last time I've streamed Jak and Daxter was back when I streamed it on Twitch. Some of the villagers will give you a power cell in exchange. Yeah, pretty much the main plot of this is, well, getting 100% on this game is pretty easy. It's just the health system is the only thing I did not like about this game. Don't you agree with me on that?
I don't know, I never played the game, so I wouldn't say exactly? Oh wait, no, I see. That heart thing, isn't it?
It's like three hits and you're dead, technically.
Oh, kind of like Spyro, like three hits without, then take an extra hit without a dragonfly and you're dead.
But in Spyro, well, the difficulty is much more easier.
Yes. True. I'm just saying for the health-wise, like. Kind of like Spyro, only except he doesn't, Jak doesn't take an extra hit once the heart is empty. So it's just like once the heart is empty, you're fucked.
It's kind of funny because when you look at Jak and Daxter in the whole initial concept of the game, it looks like it could have been Crash Bandicoot.
Technically. But didn't they dump Crash Bandicoot for this?
Yeah, they did. They dumped it way back in 1997 to come out with the idea because they heard that the PlayStation was coming out in 2000.
That's kind of lame.
To work in 1997 in order to develop this game according to.
I never understood, like, what was the point of making Crash Bandicoot and Spyro when they ran, both of them ran out of ideas.
The whole initial concept behind Crash Bandicoot was just to make three games, and that was it. Just like the concept for Jak and Daxter was the exact same thing, make three games and that's it.
I still found it kind of lame.
It was very lame.
And like, think of Insomnia Games, that they never dumped Ratchet and Clank, and they've been still doing it up to this day, really. Is there anything there? No, there's just some terrible thing over there. I don't know, some water thingy. I don't know, any new comments, by the way?
Let me scroll a little bit to the left.
It says, well, to be honest, you've done a Crash 2 stream before, but it clearly just wasn't a Let's Play Live since it was done ages ago.
Yeah.
Sandra laughed. Andrew says, yeah. And then Kupro says, the stream's actually not that delayed, to be honest.
Yeah, it's and, not that delayed.
Sandra said, me too. That made no sense.
Crazy!
Hey, sorry I'm late. My computer had to restart. Crash Bandicoot, right. Next shirt design will be Crash Team Carpet, a ref from the old world.
Oh my god! What I also hate about this game is the jump. The jump is very fucking annoying. Like, you cannot. It's like. I don't know to what game I can compare the jumping in this game, but the jumping is god awful.
The jumping was more so like. The double jump and Crash, but it was more weighty. That's what's annoying about it. Naturally, you have to do a spin attack to hover after it. And I think that was the initial concept what they was going for. It's kind of like double jumping and then spinning in Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, they kind of took the same thing from Crash.
Yeah, like I said, it's the same thing. I think pressing X and then pressing circle, I'm not sure, does like a body slam move as well. Which is also from Crash Bandicoot, except the buttons are flipped because now square is a punch button, I think.
What I hate is like, can they have when they explain you to you about something, when they give you an information, I hate when like you cannot move or anything, and the camera would be just on the thing you have to focus on. I fucking hate that in video games. I really hate that. That's one of the things that I really hated about.
It makes it seem like your only focus could be pointed on what they're talking about rather than what you.
But that fucking there, dude.
In other words, it fucking slows you down.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, if you try to speedrun this, it'll be fucking difficult since that shit is fucking annoying.
Dirt.
Here we go. It happens again. Can you skip this? No, you can't. I fucking hate that. Pick up 50 small green ecos. Yeah, the ecos are fucking annoying to collect. Like, you can die easily. That's, as I said, like, one of the things that I really didn't like about this game. How the fuck do you... Okay. Oh, there you go. Technically, you can do something from Crash Bandicoot. There you go. Which, did you realize the animation of this, you'll see in a second, is exactly like Crash Bandicoot?
Yeah, look.
The one animation again?
You'll see in a second, whenever I jump, too. Like, when you crouch jump.
Oh yeah, the high jump.
Right?
Yeah, that is very much from Crash Bandicoot. They took a lot
Everything is from Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, they took a lot of Crash Bandicoot elements into this. We're gonna head into Jabba the Hutt. Alright, let's listen to the cutscenes. I need the mic.
Good training, boys. But that's nothing compared to the challenges that lie ahead.
The similarities between this damn game and Crash are very, very...
We'd love to stay in chat, Big Green, but we're, itching to get on with our adventures.
You there?
Fine, fine.
Anyone there?
Cutscene! Away, then.
And while you're out, what is going on with the call?
Cutscene, Victor. The call is not...
I know it's... Oh, sorry.
Eco-collectors are clogged up again. Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps. They'll take you right there. Now, all of you, get out of here!
Alright, now you can unmute. Victor, we were saying, like, cutscene, Victor, cutscene.
Cutscene.
No, I kind of looked away for the intention for a bit because someone said something outside my room. When I got back, I just heard it silent. I thought the call was fucking lagging.
Now, by the way, people, here's a reference, another reference to Crash Bandicoot. Here's the plan for plant food. Returning in this game is just that it's not harmful. It's just there.
It just sits there like a... Maybe it only eats bandicoots, you know, marsupials. It prefers marsupials over friggin' people.
And right now, we're heading into the village, people. And, before we can head into that one part to actually take care of these things, we'll have to go to another area, which is right over there, I believe so. It's good that we're not collecting any eggs or whatever they're called, I forgot.
Eggs.
Aren't they precursor orbs?
I think so.
All right. Pretty much, people, we're gonna head into this area, which this is pretty much where you have to go first before anything. All right, we've just headed into the Forbidden Jungle, which in here we will have to activate this this power. I just forgot. I haven't played this game in such a long time. I've only 100%ed this game one time, people, just so you'll know.
I got another surprise for you guys. Have you ever paid attention to how Jak runs in this game and how Crash runs in Mind Over Mutant?
He kinda
It's the same run.
Yeah, it kinda does.
It's the same run. They have this flailing type of animation with their wrists. And it feels like slapping across their ass. It's the same run.
Oh, you know what? I think Crash decided to just, like, copy from Jak Daxter.
I think
it, well, you know what? Since you copied from me in the old way, I might as well fucking copy you with this.
Technically, it's same people behind it, I guess, but Crash is radical, you know.
Radical, dude!
But I guess they just looked at it and was like, well, we wanted to make it move as much as, you know, to its original sister series as possible.
One thing that I don't understand about every fan base that there is out there. Okay, people, if you've noticed, like, in every fan base, there's always these people who will try to, force their opinion. No, they will try to force their opinion on you. Like, literally, they will always try to force an opinion on you and try to make you change your opinion about something you like. Now, I really do not understand that. Like, what is the point of doing that? It's like, I don't disrespect your opinion about what you like. You should not disrespect me for the things that I like. And I see that a lot, happening a lot in the Sonic the Hedgehog group that I'm in. And people literally, oh shit, I got hit. people literally disrespect each other over an opinion about a video game, which a great example would be Sonic 06. Just because people like it, you don't have to be a prick about it.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, people will be pricks. There's no way that people won't become pricks. It's like that in every fucking fan base. It's not possible that such thing will not happen. But don't you hate that whenever somebody goes to you like, you shouldn't like this game, it's bad. It's just like, fuck off, I like it. You didn't buy the game.
I really hate it when people act as a community upon the same opinions they do that on
Birthday. Yeah, it's fucking ridiculous.
Either it's a video game or a television show, no matter what it is, they do the exact same thing.
Yep.
Then when you think, none of this sort of bullshit exists offline. Nobody's in there complaining like that. It's just online is like a place for people to vent, bitch, complain.
Pretty much.
It's stupid.
Danny, Ricky's on. He said, add me to the stream. I'm finally here.
What?
Ricky wants to be added to the stream.
Well, the problem is that we kind of have enough people, and I really hope that the call won't lag.
Well, because of who's hosting, it might end up hagging? Lagging?
Hagging.
It's just that I think it's fine the way it is for now.
It will probably delay further. So, probably not.
I'm gonna close down Viber since it's not in use. The browser is closed. Yeah. So there shouldn't be any problem. God, that frog is like chasing me. Alright. So pretty much, I forgot, what is this power thing that we're like doing?
Blue Eco? Isn't that speed?
Yeah, I have no idea what it is. It's also to like destroy things a lot easier. Kind of an invincibility kind of thing. Which is also a Crash Bandicoot ripoff.
that invisibility speed thing is more akin to Sonic.
Yeah. Imagine like literally the thing is like... Oh my god, jump! I fucking hate the jumping!
Nuku says Sonic Boom is the best Sonic game. Well, if you think so, nobody's gonna hate on that. I mean, I didn't think the game looked all too bad. It just has a freaking Ratchet and Clank and Crash Bandicoot complex. That's it.
Pretty much. Sonic Boom for the Wii U was kind
of... It's funny because it's created by those people, so I could kind of see why it happened.
When you really think about it,
thank you. Like Ratchet and Clank's creators and Crash Bandicoot's creators.
Yeah.
It was destined to happen.
Well, I want to try the game out for myself to judge it. I really do not like blind judging. It's something that it's just not me. I did not blind judge. I did not blind judge like people. I mean, not people, games in general. It's really not my style.
Wait for it to come out.
I'd rather just play the game for myself, see what's so bad.
He says, should have added a sarcasm situation there. I mean, a citation.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I guess he's saying he doesn't like it.
There we go. I think this is the last one that you had to put. Yeah, I think that is. Or not.
People want to say that game sucks, but they'll never, ever put it on the same boat as Sonic 06. I recently just saw a video where somebody said Sonic 06 makes Sonic Boom look less like Sonic 06. It's a funny video too. People are still finding glitches till this day in that game.
Yeah, it's kind of awful. Well, it doesn't matter. Like glitches are always good.
They're glitches
always
don't kill the game. Some are fucking funny. Like the other day when I'm playing this fighting game called Big Bang Beef, I made the opponent disappear. I'm like, what the fuck? Where did he go?
It's gonna be nice. Like if you're saying. Wait. It's like saying if Sonic Boom is bad, then Sonic to Insanity? What? Crash to Insanity is bad, then.
I was kind of trying to make that mention yesterday because while the gameplay does look good, the gameplay doesn't look any, like, it doesn't look shit or anything. It's just Sonic Boom is really just not very well constructed because the game isn't finished. Like, a lot of members left during its development, so that's why the game, yeah. They didn't have faith in this in the idea because the moment they noticed it was not about Sonic running fast, even the developers themselves were like, nope. But some still stuck along because Sega was pushing them to come out with the game.
Pushing the graphical limitations.
They were pushing the graphical limitations.
I fucking love that fucking quote, pushing the graphics.
You know, but instead we ended up with shit like graphics breaking. I'm just kidding.
Well, it kind of does look like a PlayStation 2 game. More than a Wii U game. A Wii U game would look more polished than that.
Well, you said something about looking like a PS2 game?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
From what I've seen, this shit looks just like the cartoon. The graphical proportions are perfect. The models are great. The problem with the game is not that. The problem with the graphics is that it's got this weird sort of unfinished look to them. Everything looks highly saturated in color, and some of the textures in rocky areas look like shit.
Yeah.
You could tell it's not finished.
Weesh! Ah, fuck!
But yeah, when you compare it to games like Sonic Unleashed and Sonic Generations, you could tell the graphics are still good. They still hold up. They don't look as good.
They don't look as good, but it's just that people judge. Like, we give a poor judgment. Actually, not even.
It doesn't really
judgment.
Look like a PS2 game because all the freaking, you know, character rigs and shit are perfectly in place. The game is perfectly rounded. You don't see any, you know, like, you know, when you look at a character and look kind of boxy, Sonic Boom doesn't have that look. Everything looks well rounded like the cartoon. The animation is where it truly lacks. Like, in some cutscenes, they're lazily done, so it makes it look like a PS2 game. Like, I've never seen that in any other game. But the reason why it happens is because of the engine that they chose. Then let's see, there's Nuku says, my favorite glitchy engine was Halo 3. And then Crazy Kari said, pushing the graphical limitations.
Grammical.
Stormtrooper 934 says, Sonic Heroes is a PS2 graphical game. Then Cool Pro said, lol, it's been a long time since I've heard the broken graphics and graphical limitations shite. And then Mischo says, I forgot the name, but there's a bike game which I'm surprised was allowed to be put on the shelves. The game was glitched to the point that you cannot finish it. Crazy Card says, anyone that calls still reading the comments.
Yep.
Cool Pro 195 says, Crash Twin Sandy wasn't glitched in bad aspects. That's why. Neither is Sonic Boom. You have to look for them.
Yep.
Sonic 06 is a game where you run into them. Sonic Boom, you have to trigger them.
Whoa, camera angle.
Camera angles and...
Yeah, and Rafis90 says, a shit ton of Jaggies and Bloom. And just know the Cry engine just wasn't suited for the Wii U. That's true as well. They had development problems with the Cry engine in the Wii U. Like, the initial, like, trailer that they showed, the area ended up being in the game, but was really different looking. And Adrian Bandic says, notice me, Senpai.
Adrian Brody.
That says Dingle doesn't celebrate Christmas, I think.
Wait, what? Freaking crash.
Yahoo, Basil!
Pancakes! Ah, fuck! Sorry. Ah, shit! I fucking fell down. Would you fucking jump, you twat cunt? I nearly fell down. Stupid cunt.
No shit.
You fucking cunt. Alright, we're gonna hind. We're gonna hind? What? Are you a fuck? Sorry, I just fell down.
I already know what I'm doing.
Why am I always falling down at the worst times?
Daddy's always falling down.
Oh
falling
my god,
down.
I nearly fell down again. Fuck's sake. Alright. Yowie, yow, fuck!
Oh, you yowie, what? Yowie, fuck!
What did you say, yowie, fuck?
Rafis says Dingo needs a hug.
No, wait.
Ain't that sweet?
Ain't that sweet, yellow.
What's next?
Isn't that switching?
Sonic Boom wasn't glitched in crucial aspects either. That was the wrong word to use, says CoolPro195. Kinda was. From what I've seen in many reviews, it wasn't the actual glitches in the game that made it bad. It was the gameplay. Like, everything works fine, but according to them, it brought nothing new to the table, and as a result,
it's
a giant game that suffers from its own ideas. I say that's stupid because, like, gamers always expect to get something new all the time out of video games.
Also,
you can only do so much.
Gamers expect way too much.
They do.
Yes.
And especially when it's a big name. When it's a big name, oh god, it's a nightmare. If it's a big name, randomly everything has to be good.
Yeah.
That's another thing I genuinely dislike. Like, they can't have some games that are better than others. Because all of them have to be equally good.
Yep.
Oh, shit. Kill your shit.
Just because it's a big series. Sonic can never slip up. Crash can never slip up. None of them can ever slip up.
Mm-hmm. Which is annoying as fuck. I never understood that, really.
Every series has to have a bad game in order to really be a series.
Technically.
I mean, when you think about it, even Mortal Kombat, and that's just a fighting game, has a bad game. Which was ironically not a fighting game. They had Mortal Kombat Special Forces, which was an action-adventure game about Jax. It sucked.
Yeah.
Like, Every real series has a like point where they fall. Even Jak and Daxter had that. It was freaking Jak X Combat Racing. But like, everyone expected.
Okay, why does every fucking game get a racing game? That's so fucking.
Yeah, that's why it was considered bad. Like, they were doing the same shit that, you know, they did with freaking Crash.
Mortal Kombat is not a game for racing, really.
No.
Yeah, Mortal Kombat has a racing game, though. That's funny.
I know, it's just that it's stupid.
It's stupid, but Motor Kombat is hilarious, though.
Did you say Motor Kombat?
Yeah, that's what the game is called. There's a racing game of Mortal Kombat called Motor Kombat.
Fucking stupid.
Yeah, it's a racing game, but it's kind of like a mini game, but you can't really say it's a mini game because it's actually a full game where you can unlock characters. It's just on Mortal Kombat Armageddon, which is the final game on the PS2. It's a game inside of a game.
Yahoo!
And that game's freaking hilarious.
And we've got another thing, whatever it's called. I love how every time you get that thing, they're doing, like, different dances.
Sometimes they play the same shit. It's like, wow.
I hate this thing. What? Here's another reference to Crash Bandicoot. Didn't you realize that every time you jump, there was... In which Crash Bandicoot game was that? Oh, the monkey in Crash Bandicoot 3! Whenever you jump on it, and then, like, it gives you, Wumpa Fruits?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
This is exactly like that. I just noticed that.
Like I said, Jak and Daxter was just their open world replacement for Crash.
Technically, you can say this is Crash Bandicoot 4.
Yep.
In a way, it's, yes, it is true.
It's really just Crash Bandicoot, but with different characters.
By the way, people, we collected all of the orbs. And we also, I think they're called orbs. We collected all the other shit. Woohoo!
Yes.
So we're literally done with this. Fuck! Sorry. We're literally done with this area. Oh, wait. No, no, not really. Give me a second, me friendly cunt. Yeah, cunt. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, let's do this fishing challenge, which I really hated.
Yeah. What's the matter, bird, you silly, silly bugger? No matter what
I
try, I can't
seem to catch a single fish in this river. I never liked the, when the game is saving on Jak and Daxter, they have that freaking, what do you call that? The check on the memory card. Because it's red like that, it indicates it's a problem with the memory card. Rather than it actually being like, okay, we're good, it's saving. Why they didn't make it green instead?
Alright, let's do this challenge. There are two types of good fish to catch. 1 pound fishies and 5 pound fishies. I love how like the body of the fish moves, but the eyes do not move at all. I'm gonna take me net back from you. There are poisonous eels. Yeah, we have to catch even one of them boogers. If we catch one of the poisonous ones, we're in a problem. It's gonna screw up our whole thing. I love how it's like, here goes the big one. And it reminds me of that video. No, the big one.
Oh, that fucking YouTube poop. No, big one. No, big one. It's like, fucking what?
And they're like, it's still at a certain point. It's like, no, the big one.
And, so wait, the green fish is wave, okay?
Yeah, each wave, there's... Oh, shit. There's like a row of fishes that's supposed to come to your ship. Here comes a big one! And every time
Ratchet and
one,
Clank... Yeah, that is kind of something they would do, Leon. Like, call the Ratchet and Clank racing game Ratchet and Clank Deep Tunnel Racing or some shit. Because they always make sexual references with, like, every game in the U.S. I don't know why they do that. They probably laugh behind the scenes, but everything is making a big sexual sentence with Ratchet and Clank.
What the fuck? All the enemies! Look how many bad fishes are coming through. Holy shit.
I see mostly good ones at the moment. And you only missed two.
Oh, shit. And each wave... Oh, what?! If you miss 20, you lose? That is gay.
Well, they give you a good chance, didn't it? It's like, you know, 20. It's not like miss 3 fish and you're fucked. No!
I fucking hate these challenges. And each wave it goes faster. And all we caught is just 18 of these assholes.
I don't like challenges in platformers. I want platforming, not challenges. That's why I'm glad that Twin Sanity made a joke about that.
I'll give you this power crystal.
Get these challenges out of my fucking platforming game. Platforming, not challenges. It's just like something you would do in Spyro the Dragon.
I caught one of these assholes. I wonder how long this challenge will take me.
Well, to be more fair, this is more of an action-adventure game rather than just some platformer. So.
Yeah.
So the challenge is
making. While you're holding a controller where you're trying to play a game, your eye itches.
Yes!
Mainly it's like my head that itches.
Oh, the head, that's even worse.
Oh my god, there's certain like challenges like this in Sonic Adventure as well. Like Amy has to fucking hit like she has to play like what do you call that game when you bop the head of shit? God, it's called like whack-a-mole or some shit.
Whack-a-mole?
You gotta get up to like a certain amount of points to win.
Oh no! I just lost.
You caught an asshole again.
And you hit supersonic and you get more points.
Oh my god, I nearly got it! How many do you need? 200?
That's what the fucking guy said, didn't he? What? The golden fish give you bigger points, and...
I love how it refreshes, like, the fish that, the fishes that are coming through. It's like, it refreshes, like, what comes to you. That's one thing I kinda liked about this game, that it refreshes, like, it's not the same thing that you have to do over again.
Here comes a big one!
No, the big one!
If you get like just one of the bad fish, it fucks up. That's the annoying part about this.
You collect the bad one, no matter how much you've got, buddy, you're gonna miss.
You gotta put your dick in it.
I thought you said you were gonna yiff.
And now we have more people here.
Yeah, no matter how good you get, you gotta fucking put
let's
your
see,
dick in it.
Crazy. Kari says, did you know one of the titles Insomniac Games came up for All for One is multiple orgasms?
Nice!
Yeah, or organisms, my bad. Multiple organisms. Okay. I don't know why I read it as
Love
orgasms.
It.
Oh no!
Nope, I admit I didn't.
Oh my god.
Okay, Oddworld Munch's Odyssey HD is definite. I mean, it's officially on the PS Vita as well. As it up your arse wasn't enough.
You and Tasty is a good one. It's like a remake of the very first.
The movie game will be called Ratchet and Clank, the first one. The movie.
Oh, the movie. I want to see the movie.
I
That's fun.
Wait.
That's a funny title, Ratchet and Clank, the first one.
Mr. Game. The first. Oh, yeah. Hey, guys, I'm going to watch a Ratchet and Clank movie. Which one? The first one. That would be the fucking hilarious thing for a conversation.
The movie
like,
will
hey, guys.
Be called Ratchet and Clank, the first one, the movie.
No, but seriously, though, it's like, hey guys, we're gonna watch a movie. What do you want to watch? Ratchet and Clank, which one? The first one.
Movie.
First one, the movie. What?
How is it like I'm missing so many? And how am I supposed to avoid these assholes?
I mean, think
easy,
about
just
all
keep
the
your
ratchet.
Fucking eye on them.
Here comes the big one! Here comes
the
big one! Big one!
That big one!
Just so much dirty titles from...
Did you say Gay Boy or Stay Boy?
The Ratchet and Clank series.
I thought he said Gay Boy!
No, I lost it! Man! They give me like this fucking like... music that's like dun, dun. I fucking hate
okay,
that.
Okay, folks.
It's like you fucking
we've got
died.
This, you know, we've got Ratchet and Clank going commando up your arsenal deadlock because size matters with tools of destruction on the quest of booty at the crack of time into the Nexus. It's a full frontal assault that's all for one, and we're going mobile.
The Ratchet and Clank. Fuck! Sorry.
The Ratchet and Clank. Fuck!
The Ratchet and Clank.
The Ratchet and Clank series has hilarious fucking names to the titles. What the fuck? I wish.
Steady boy. Here comes a big one.
I wish they had more gold fucking assholes than this. Looks like you could
use a bigger thing. Gold assholes.
Imagine a piece of ass floating down the fucking stream. Just no bodies attached, just an ass.
And it's gold.
You said ass? Yeah, it's a golden ass. It's a poisonous ass that farts a lot. Golden ass that's like freaking solid gold or whatever.
You're reminding me of Golden Axe when people say golden ass instead of golden axe. Golden.
How is it possible not to miss those cunts? It's literally impossible.
Steady boy. Gay boy. I keep hearing gay boy.
No, it sounds steady
gay boy.
Gay boy. Yes, you are. Alright, come on.
You don't remember that freaking song from Dooley?
Yeah. Yes, we are indeed almost there, you stupid granny. Enough fish for yourself, bitch. There we go, we did it! Wahoo, guys, we got a boner!
Their last game, Ratchet and Clank checking out. Either they got some AIDS or someone has ass face going on. Says Leon.
By the way, any more comments besides that?
Adrian Brony, I'm just kidding.
Adrian Brony?
Actually, Adrian Bandic says, wish washed. And I like to ask, kind of like, what's up with Bandic? Is that like his actual name? Or...
His name is, his Bandic. Username is Adrian Bandic, pretty much. His name is Adrian.
Because when you read Bandic, it's like Bandic, like a bandicoot dick or something. That's why
nice.
I was Bandic. What?
What?
I don't like how that feels when I say that. Okay.
Oh,
yeah. Gotta get my mind out of the gutter. Alright, Stormtrooper 93 says Mario and Sonic are having a movie made by Sony. I understand Sonic. But a Mario movie made by Sony?
No. Nintendo has a lot, you know, I can somehow image Nintendo trying to make a movie for once.
If they make a crossover movie, that would actually be very interesting. Make a game based off of that so it could flop, just like Sonic Boom. I'm just kidding. Because for some reason, movie games always don't work out well.
Yes, exactly. Like
I'm
the fucking
about
Legend Transformers.
Oh, let's talk to this granny.
Crazy Kari says, it's time for Crazy Taxi, I'm just kidding. Yeah, a New Year's stream would be great. Cool Pro says that one is fucking amazing.
People, we will be doing a New Year's Eve stream, and we will also be doing a Christmas stream. That's gonna base on stages that are Christmas themed from various games. So I'll have to prepare.
That's actually a very interesting concept. I think you should do that. But is there like a snow level? Wait, you might have to get Sonic Adventure, buddy. Ice Cap Zone for both Sonic Adventure and
Well, there's Sonic 3.
Sonic 3 as well. They both have snow levels.
What's like that the music makes? The music
levels.
is so weird that like, I'm just staring at this like, what's the name of this animal that you're trying to get back into the cage? Forgotten like.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like the music makes me stare at their ass. It's just like wiggles to the music.
Oh really? How long have we been staring at their asses, huh?
Come on, wiggle that butt.
What you do with a big old butt? Wiggle.
Preferring bestiality, I'm just kidding.
Victor's into that kind of shit. Wait,
no, fuck that shit.
Victor loves bestiality. He's done Lucy.
Oh yeah. Yeah, the music.
Lucy. I'm gonna lick that pussy.
Ah,
fuck. Alright, there we go.
Hiya! I love how he has so much power over these yaks that just all he has to do is walk behind them for them to just go there.
Yeah.
Not like Spyro, he had to charge up his asshole or flame it.
Yeah, and Spyro, he had to freaking horn the ass of freaking cow whatever the hell.
Cowlax, yeah. I've lost my cowlax. I'm little Poppy, but I lost my cowlax.
Man, how the fuck did you do like a double jump and... Oh yeah, I forgot that you're supposed to do this. I forgot, I'm so stupid. Exactly when I nearly fell off the fucking edge.
Crazy Kari says the ultimate penetration.
Oh
holy
my god.
Dying. What about Jazz Jizz Rabbit? I'm just
what about Giselle has him?
Giselle Owen the Rabbit. I'm just
Oh, this is much better.
Adrian Bandic says, I hate Fire Canyon.
Hello there, Adrian Brody.
Adrian Brody. Adrian Brody. Adrian Brody. I'm just.
Ah, I knew you were going to say it.
I love saying that. You as the light
within. You. From before time, I have watched and
waited for the true hero to return. Yeah, we know Jak and Daxter's jump sucks. 120
precursors.
That jump is really miserable.
Yep, there we go. Another power cell
is yours. The rolling jump.
Crash needs to teach him how to jump.
Crash, I got a job for you. Yeah, you see this asshole right here? Teach him how to jump, because he can't seem to jump for shit.
The long jump, yep.
Yeah, Crash is way better. Whenever it comes to jumping, that is.
Epic fail,
says Adrian Bandit.
Just call him Adrian Brody.
Adrian Brody.
Ah, fuck. Sorry. Did he say hook yak or whatever?
Hook yak?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean that ground pound move or something?
You need one more. You need one more of them fuckers from this eyeball.
Yeah. I know.
But it's got two of them, doesn't it? I mean, he has to get the other one.
There you go. Now I can actually get the other one.
Imagine if he screams as he removed that eye. He'd be like, oh god, the pain in my eye! Oh wait, I don't have it anymore.
Oh, my leg!
Oh, my leg!
Twisted!
Oh! Sorry.
Jesus fucking lord. I would just throw that stupid ass bird out the window.
It'll fly.
No! He can fly, yes, his wings isn't clipped.
What was that, a Moo Moo Fly face? What the fuck was that you just collected?
Moo Moo Fly face?
That's what it looks like.
The fuck's a Momo Club face or whatever?
Momo.
Oh, you mean that bug thing?
Yeah, it looks like a cow fly thingy.
It's just like a fly. That's all it is. And we've collected the oldest.
I beg to differ.
I beg your vagina. No, I'm just kidding. Woohoo!
What? Black Doom is the statue, what? Said Stormtrooper 934. Adrian Brandy. Adrian Brandy.
Adrian Brody. Adrian Brody.
Says, Crash Bash was effing legacy.
This is Crash Bandicoot 4, by the way, people. Wait,
says, Brody Quest was legacy, too.
Brody Quest. The fucking Brody Quest was fucking hilarious. Why am I hearing like somebody playing the keyboard in a game or some shit?
I have no idea, fucking dude, you know?
Let's talk to the granny. Actually, no. But isn't there like any boxes? Yes, there is one over here. Yeah. Right.
Did you get my frame request, Dingle Crash?
Who?
This Trooper 934.
I think I did. If he's talking on PSN, then I did. So many places to see. I'm not on PSN, by the way. I'm playing on a PS3, but I'm logged out, so my connection won't lag. That's something I've learned that I should do. Otherwise, my connection will go apeshit if I do that.
Leon says, laugh my ass off, the statue sounds like one of Victor's voices when he voice acts.
Wahoo! Hell yeah, motherfucker!
Why do these houses strangely remind me of Crash's house?
It kinda does.
Just a whole bunch of them.
We're getting all such the SpongeBob area. House.
Alright! Treasure!
Treasure, I hope so.
Oh yeah, that Dingo now.
Treasure, I?
Her treasure, eh? Bonsai.
Ah, fuck! I only got hit. You have to pretty much let this retard throw these bombs at like these treasure chests. Indeed, more orbs, you fucking cunt.
Lol.
Bullshit. Yeah. Oh, there we go. The bird took the one of the.
That pelican just snagged a power cell.
The power cell. I need to learn how things are called in this fucking game. Yeah, this area is pretty nice. We're currently on Insanity Beach, by the way, people. So
it looks like that.
That fucking pelican.
It's actually fun. Jak and Daxter, they made sure Jak and Daxter was a fun platformer.
They did, but what they didn't like even put a focus on was the music, sadly. Like, all the fun stuff from the game, not the music. The music is boring. It's like, it's freaking, we're doing a live stream. I'm supposed to talk.
What?
Just skip that.
Wait, what?
Pretty much,
Wait, go back to that. What just happened?
Nothing, just forget it.
Who said what?
I just said, like, my brother was complaining, that's it.
Okay.
But, as I was saying, with the music in this game, it's well done, like, it's perfectly orchestrated, but they don't seem to have many tracks that people tend to remember often. It's kind of been like that for most of Sony's games. Like, yeah. Sony is a company, when they make platformers and such, the music is kind of forgettable.
Yeah.
It's more so the experience that was more memorable. Like, you could see, like, something for Crash Bandicoot. And, you will remember the tracks, like, really fast, but when it comes to games like Jak and Daxter, Ratchet and Clank and such, all you remember is the orchestrated sound of the game. And that's pretty much it.
I love how the thing that got out of the egg is just like, Mama! It's freaking adorable.
I'm not your mom! You see any feathers here?
Love at first sight. Listen, boys.
Shit,
swear.
I know,
it's like,
or how did
your mom? Oh, the poor baby. Look what you've done. You fucking killed it. And then, oh, look, it's alive.
Yeah, look at that corner.
It's a beautiful little baby bird, though. I like it.
Yeah, it's a little corner. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, so pretty much like, I don't know, it could have been a Crash Bandicoot game. Maybe they should have tried to, you know.
And I'm sorry getting back on this topic now since he walked out and shit. He's complaining a little too much about me talking, even though the middle of the day I virtually said nothing because it wasn't even a goddamn call up anyway.
You should tell your brother to go kill himself.
Just left the room.
Yeah.
Just saying, fucking stupid. Not even making noises or anything, just fucking talking.
Jesus. It's not like you're playing porno music in the background. It's like, Victor, turn that shit down!
I'm not even loud. He's like, bitching at me.
No, it's your brother, what do you expect?
Stupid.
Alright, so right now we're destroying these rocks because under there's a thing that restores our health, which is pretty useful. Yay! And we got a power cell or whatever. How many of them we have? We have 16.
Looks like,
we've got 16 of them.
Well, I see that you two
and we also managed to get these things that let you jump higher. Here they are over there.
Daxter could always get
a job fuck you. The village rat fuck you. Yeah. Alright, there we go. Whee! There we go. Jumped on the right roof. Roof. Alright. What do you think, this, in terms of difficulty, do you think this game is easy? Because I think it's kind of medium difficulty.
I have no idea.
This game, to me, was a game that... it's one of those games that start off easy, but then it nosedives into a direction I never want to visit again. It's one of those type of games, like, by the end of it, it's just so damn frustrating.
Yeah.
God, and the games after it got so much worse. They were hard all the time. That's why I gave up on the Jak series. Because of the direction. Yeah, the difficulty climbed in 2 and 3 and so forth. Because the premise changed. You know, it became more like GTA, and I mean, GTA is about the only game I would play that's that damn hard like that. And I really don't like it when games do that most of the time. If it's gonna be easy, you know, just have that curve to where it starts easy but then gets harder over time. But not freaking OP'd where the game feels completely different from when you played it in the beginning. When the game naturally feels like it's just a hard ball game, that's when it's too damn hard.
No,
still
never,
good though. It's a good game.
I never felt that this game was way too difficult. It is difficult in a way. It's just that the difficulty is not that, you know, big.
Yeah, it's not. That's why I said the sequels. The sequels is where, you know, I pulled the curtain.
Fucking enemies. Fucking hate these enemies. Fucking annoying. And they follow you. That's the most annoying thing. I remember in Gex, I think everybody remembers this. In Gex 3, like, whenever enemy, like, they're in the Christmas stage. It's called Holiday Channel. Pretty much, like, the enemy is like, you better run, or some shit like, and then they run away from you. It's just like, what?
Stormtroopers in 394 they have the same opinions.
What?
Stormtrooper 934 said me and Victor have the same opinions. Okay, let's see. Token Black says Daxter was an easy game. Well,
Daxter
yeah,
was
Daxter
fun.
Was easy, but I didn't count fun. Daxter in the mainstream series. It just tells how he went to save Jak after the first game, I think. Like, during that process, how did he go and save him? Which was a good idea. But I don't mainly count it as that. I count it as like a spin-off. Especially since they just shoved the game on the PSP. I don't even think they ever shoved that game on the PS2.
Yeah, they never put it on the PS2. I wish
but
they
then
did,
put,
though.
Then they put Jak 4 on there, which was like, what? Why they couldn't do that for the other one? Who knows?
Who knows?
Uno, right? I wonder if Uno's on PS4.
Probably.
I wonder if Uno's on PS4. I might check it out later. Unless somebody's already checked it and say, sorry, no Uno on PS4 just yet. But still, I would love to play it on PS4. Do a stream on Twitch or something, and I'll be like, hey guys! Join the fun!
Stormtrooper 934 says, why a game so buggy nowadays? Back then they weren't nearly as buggy. There's a logical reason to that, because the game testers are, well, not professional game testers anymore. You know, they're supposed to play the games all day and look for bugs, and people aren't really doing their job like that anymore. Some just get ordinary gamers to do it. Such as the fighting game community. As a result, you end up with a game that's, well, more buggy than the predecessor.
Oh,
a big
God.
Example is, like, Mortal Kombat 9, which was like less buggy than Injustice. Injustice was a buggy ass fighting game, but they had to patch it to fix it.
Yeah.
Then you have platformers that are very buggy as well. But for unlike those games, platformers never seem to get patches. Like, all these complaints about Sonic Boom could be fixed if only they patched it, but the company shut down as fast as they developed the game. Which is very strange. Like, Big Red Button creates this game, Big Red Button disappears forever.
No, seriously though, I remember doing some beta testing once on a game when Little Big Planet 2 was about to come out on the PS3. I did beta testing, and I have this little coat thing as evidence. So I got this coat. Holy crap, it was really awesome. I remember the reaction when Sam saw me got it, right? When Sam got me in the lift on PSN. Holy shit, he was like, "You lucky bitch, give me the thing," and I'm like, "No, get your own."
Yeah, that's another thing. The beta testing, like. They get people to, like I said, the fans to play the game.
Yeah, and it was fun. It was great.
Pay professional people like that to really do it anymore.
I know, but I'm just saying, I've tried it before, right? Because I was like one of the lucky few that was testing it, and it was fun. And I did manage to report a few bugs, like saying, "Yeah, you see this bit? This has got a bug. I'd report that there's a bug right there on this part specific bit. Fix that, and you know."
Yay! I killed this enemy! Fuck you!
Yay! Fuck you! I have this shit!
Alright, we've collected another precursor orb, I think. No, power crystal. What the fuck ever.
Crash Stefano said, on the other hand, back then when a game was glitchy, it was completely doomed. No chance of redemption unless a new version of that game was released. Yeah, that is true.
Lol, I love this. Stormtrooper said the code was accidentally leaked into the PSN store, so I got it free in Little Big Planet 3. Ah! Thank you for the info. And Kupro said they should bring Uno.
More harsh. Now these days, games can get patches and all this to make the game.
I love this how Kupro said they should bring Uno PS4 if it's not already. Well, I agree with Kupro. They should be. Fucking bird! Be quiet! Do you want me to get the balloon?
You should get the balloon, for fuck's sake. The bird is
if he screams one more
ears.
I'm sorry, but if he does that one more time, I am definitely using the balloon. I'm telling you that now.
Fucking retarded bird. It's like the worst animal to bring to a house is a bird.
Not all birds are like that, thankfully. Not all birds are like that.
All birds are noisy.
No, I said not all of them. Some of them are quite docile and they don't make that much noise like he does. There are animals that are completely docile. There are some, like, a cockatiel. Instead of screaming, they sing a cute little tune. That's really, really sweet. But, you know, doing something like Kai's doing, that's not a good idea, you know? Like, Jesus Christ.
Am I missing something? I think I am.
Just get a parakeet. At least it doesn't make noises. Just copies you.
Chase the seagulls.
You're a faggot. You're a faggot, girl.
No, that's a bigger one. I think Cockatoo probably would say that because it's got better vocal. Or a African Grey, I think it was. No, African Grey, maybe. Because I saw this one point in the video, right? There was this big African Grey was being noisy, and the father went like, "Shut up, bad boy," all the time, right? And then the African Grey went, "Fuck you," and the guy went, "Fuck you," back to the bird. I'm not joking. I saw a video that African Grey birds can swear, and it went, "Fuck you." It was something funny when he said that. It's like, wow.
Yeah, there's.
Didn't have any idea what it was saying.
Probably. At least you know what he wanted to say!
It reminds me of the freaking Scary Movie bird.
Holly wants your mama, sweet ass!
What did you just say about my mama?
Don't talk about my mama like that, son! Don't know my mama like that, son! Yes, I do! I fucked her last night!
And then this guy went... And it was like, "Hey, calm down, man, it's just a bird." He goes like, "Oh, yeah. It's just a, you know, you probably made him mad or something." And he goes like, "Something, you fucking four eyes." And he was like, "You what? Come on, bro, I'm on
It's like, back off, four eyes.
And back off,
four eyes.
Am I missing someone? Because I think I'm missing five of these
orbs.
Oh wait, I know where they are. There we go. I always seem to forget certain things in here.
Hey, yeah.
Whenever he does that freaking high jump with that thing, it reminds me of like Ratchet and Clank with ooh yeah and shit.
So you do need to collect those fucking egg things. I keep calling them eggs because of the shape.
Alright, we've collected all of them. Except we're missing just one thing. Wait. Sandover Village? We've got 49 out of 50. Well, we'll collect them. Sends you a bitch. Bitch? Beach.
Life's a bitch. I mean, life's a beach.
The parrot said,
"What the fuck are you supposed to raise this thing or whatever?" Because I don't see any challenge really over here.
Yet.
No, I just don't see any challenges over here. I don't know. There's like this part where you're supposed to chase something. You're supposed to chase the seagulls or whatever.
You're supposed to chase their mama.
Look at that, he can do the one thing that Crash can't do.
And what's that?
Swim.
Picking his nose?
Swim. That's the massive difference right there.
Oh yeah. He can't do that belly flop. I think he'll hurt his fucking stomach if he did that. He'd be like, oh!
Well, seeing how Street Fighter V was with the fucking noodles falling on your head, I'm thinking they're about to do some way more embarrassing shit like Fatal Fury. Because Fatal Fury used to do shit like that. Except it was never escalated that far. You can knock people out of the freaking arena at the end of the match, or you can knock them towards the screen, or some shit like that. You can knock them into some band equipment and they get shocked. I think they're gonna have embarrassing finishes in Street Fighter V just like that.
By the way, can somebody tell me what I'm exactly missing? Because
I'm not sure. I haven't played this game in years, so I don't know a thing about it.
Vicky, can you actually look it up? Like in Sentinel Beach, chase the
Sentinel Beach.
Hang on one minute. Let me just make this window bigger.
Just a minute. I'll be right back, guys. I need to make myself something to eat.
All right.
Daxter.
So I'm kind of stuck right now.
There you go. Check in Daxter. There it is. Let's see. Wiki.
Because you're supposed to chase the seagulls, and I have no idea.
One minute. Walk through the fast. Okay. Hang on one minute. Chase the seagulls was a mission. Blah blah blah. Okay. Walkthrough says on the far side of the central beach. Three large stone sentinels rest on the sand. On the first, there is a flock of seagulls. Hop up onto the platform and scare them away. Repeat this two times for each sentinel. Where after a cutscene will show the seagulls causing a small landslide. The power cell will pop out, landing atop a small platform next to a large rock. So has also fallen from the cliffside and free for the taking.
I have no idea where the fuck that place is.
It's supposed to be like a platform. One minute.
Tell me.
Three
exactly.
Large stones. It says so. That's what it says on the wiki, right? On the wikia. It says on the far side of Sentinel Beach, three large stones. Yeah, I can't fucking read that word. I don't know why. Sentinels.
Sentinel?
I think it meant Sentinel, that's it. Three stone Sentinel rest on the sand. So it has to be somewhere on the sand, and it has to be three tall or large stone. So you had to find them somewhere there.
Okay, I know that there's like these three buildings or some shit.
Oh, there it is. There's a video of a walkthrough someone did that. TPL. What the hell is a TPL?
The Precursor Legacy.
Oh.
That's what it means.
Right. Alright, there's the seagulls. I want to find this picture image so I can see where the fuck they are.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, no, wait, never mind.
Kind of.
You need to scare them. So they will let me go landslide.
Escape from reality. Open your eyes. Shit up in the sky. See. I'm just a poor soul. I have no sympathy. Because easy come, easy come.
Somehow I knew.
Every word the wind blows, nothing really matters to me.
I love that. Adrian said they were in front of you, man. Laugh. He just don't eat it in time. Let's see. Crank that soda. Crank that soda. What the fuck, Leon?
I get the reference.
Crank that soda.
So it's a funny reference.
Ah, why is this? Well, I never know.
What the fuck?
I don't know. All I just felt like doing it.
There is like a faster way to actually move in this game, and I'm nearly fucked up something. This literally could have been a Crash Bandicoot game, don't you think?
This could have, yes. Lol, like a fucking crossover.
You wish.
I imagine some. Lol, I would laugh if someone actually did a piss take and like a fucking crossover game of Crash and Jack, and it would be like. You know how we like that music? That guy goes do 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 do. It's something like that bad.
I thought you meant like the do 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 do.
That's what I meant. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Fire canyon. Oh god. This is gonna be great.
Hurry, my father's an asshole.
That was my father.
Yay!
I think we're gonna collect everything from here.
Wait, wasn't he really her father, or was he an adopted father?
He was a con.
Lol. That was a good answer!
He was a con. It's just as simple as that. He was a con. He was a fucking con.
Oh, I love that. Crazy Carrie says, still want to know why the birdie is scared of balloons. Because he just does. You can't handle the truth behind balloons.
It's a stupid
it's
bird.
Just because fucking hell, you trying to, you know, sometimes he won't get mad. He won't be scared of you if you're trying to, like, you know, if you want to pick him up with your hands, he'll bite you if he doesn't want you to pick him up, right? He won't be scared of you, oh no! But when it comes to balloons, like, wave it, just not even touch him, just wave it in front of him, he'll freak the fuck out. I'm telling you that now.
I'm missing one of these things with the bee containers or whatever in here. Just in the, unlike the mainland, which I'm trying to look for. Kinda difficult to find them. It's like you literally have to go into like every house in order to find them all. I know there was one. I got the one from over there. Get one from over there. It's just difficult.
Guy, what are you eating? It better not be one of your feathers.
No.
I swear, that little shit barbers for no reason. I mean, Yeah, birds scared of balloons. Wow. Yes, it is weird. But I'm telling you that. Even when Sis did everything she could to make the bird happy, feeds him, clean his cage every day, let him out for 2 hours or so, and fucking shit like that, he still barbers like a freaking retard, I'm telling you that now. And I mean, I can understand if it was in summer, but in the winter time? Seriously? He wants to catch a pneumonia? Seriously? You're gonna barb- No, I mean, it's bad enough he barbers the front of himself and the back of himself, right, under the wings. The next thing he did a little bit, he barbers his tail. Next thing he'll barber his fucking wings. Let's see he gets away now. Put in cage time and try and fly away, but he can't because he fucking barbers his wings. And he'd be like, yeah, try to fly away now, asshole. I had to use a coat hanger to put him back in the cage. You know that? He's that... apparently he deprogrammed himself of hand taming. That if you want to put him away in a cage, he'll fucking bite you. He'll fucking bite you. So I had to use a coat hanger to prevent getting bitten. Not to smack him or anything, just to make him step up, put him in the cage, and that's it. Just simple as that. Miserably ugly one. Might
have just pilfered him as a sort of a spot of fun. Freaking Daxter is like all pissed off.
Wouldn't you? 90
precursor orbs. I think so that the, like, Daxter is a great design for a character.
Was that Leon? But Vicky Crash can't get jacked by Daxter. That's just wrong.
What?
That's what Leon just said.
Crash cannot get jacked by Daxter.
And Adrian said, I saw what you did there. What a bird she has. Yes, what a bird he has indeed. I mean, before that bird was brought home for the first time, he used to be sweet and everything. And at first he would be alright, but then later on in freaking life, he decided to deprogram himself. He decided to be a dick like he just did now. And freaking... And, you know... Oh, what a wonderful
sight. It's not surprising me, really. The bird is a complete prick.
I know, I mean, like I said, not all birds are like that, thank God for that. I mean, there are some canoes that are probably more freaking docile than him. Because that's what Kailani is, yellow-sided green-cheek canoe?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Yeah, he has nice color on his feathers, but the shame is that whenever he does this fucking... Wait a minute, what? How does one use a coat hanger? How does one use of a coat hanger to put a bird in a cage?
I do have
How does?
90, no, I don't have any... I don't have 90 orbs. Like, I have to get 90 orbs in order to get, like... Or is it called orbs? Wait, yeah, orbs.
Diamond Key just asked, how does one use a coat hanger to put a bird in a cage? Well, it's simple, really. It's just simply just like... There's a coat hanger that you don't use to hang clothes. Like, say, for example, it used to be alright, but it kind of broke, but it's not broken enough to hurt the bird. It's just like, as long as, you know, just pick him up from the safe side, he gets up, put him right inside the cage, you know, with the hanger inside the cage, put him up right up to where the perch is so he can climb up the perch, and then I just go, whoop, take the hanger out and close the cage. That's it. Nothing major bad or anything, just... Like, you know, make a step up on hand, but a coat hanger instead, because when putting him back, he will bite you. And when he bites you, it's like a blistery, bloody, bruisey, fucking swelling bite, I swear to God. One time, I could have sworn I had a nearly permanent scar from him.
Wow.
At first, I thought I had a permanent scar, but it's almost gone. Like, it's been stubborn for months, but it's this freaking close of getting permanent, and yet it's nearly gone. It's like, took months to keep. Heal, I'm telling you that now. Oh, great. Oh, a finch. My sister once had a finch. He was called a lavender finch, right? A fire lavender finch, I think. He used to be called Aramis, but unfortunately, the poor little bugger died. I noticed him dying. I mean, it was the very first time I noticed an animal was dying of old age. Absolutely first time in my life. And I went to Sis and tell Sis that I think Aramis is dying. So Sis went up to the bird and picked Aramis up and then holds him. And the poor little bugger died in her hands of old age.
It was adorable. That's adorable. That's fucked up.
Yeah, you meant to say it's sweet but sad at the same time, sort of thing. But yeah, it was really sad for all of us. Even Sis cried, and yet later on she denied, saying, oh, I'm just doing that so I don't look like a dick. I'm like, please, don't talk bullshit.
Yeah, it's like...
Mom was upset, Dad was upset, I was upset, even Sis was upset. It was like, the whole family was upset because the bird died.
This is fucking scary.
Oh, you mean like if it overheats, bang. You had to pick up all the balloons all the way, right?
Oh, I fucking blew up. Fuck!
you didn't make it
in time. How the fuck do you jump?
I have no idea. X button?
No, X is something else. Oh, there you go. It's like L1.
Here's just a legitimate, like, small little thing about that character. Isn't she a bit too busty for a kid's game? They let Tawana, like, I mean, they didn't let Tawana, like, carry on, but they let this character do it, like,
why? Because it's not, you know...
Not just her, there's that other enemy, too. Like, that was busty as shit. There's, like, another person in the game, one of the main villains. Yeah, I'm gonna check on my noodles. Be right back.
Alright. Weesh! Gotta love them noodles. No. I need one of these things to cool off.
Fucking hell, what the hell is it? Holy shit, hang on. Victor?
Hey, Victor's on BRB.
I'm gonna post a picture. I just found this fucking picture of the Simpsons. I swear to God, that was like Ned Flanders with no nose, no neck between his fingers, fucking neck not even popping out of his shirt. It's like, what the fuck is this? I'm not joking. We found it on Tumblr.
Ah, fuck. Oh shit, I got hit. Whee! Ah, fuck. Oh, so close. By the way, any new comments? Vicky.
Yeah, what?
New comments, right. I'll have a look.
Let's see. I started having visions of cats everywhere since I started playing Gravity Rush for some reason, said Crash the fan. I'm not joking, that's what he said. Nothing else besides that.
I'm nearly dead. Yay! We've got the, what is it called? I forgot what's the name of that thing.
Yeah.
Thank God! We've collected them all. We've got two of these power thingies, power orbs, whatever. Forgot the name. It's like literally, I'm very terrible at memorizing certain things with these games. And when I'm going for 100%, we're literally what? How long are we into this part?
I don't know. Hang on, let's see. We're at like 1 hour 26 minutes at the moment.
So literally, we're barely even far into the game. And I'm trying to aim for 100%. Now...
Lol.
Well, that's what you what happens when you aim for 100%. I'm thinking of maybe adding somebody to the call.
Ooh, who are you gonna add?
Come on, have a look. One pop each, well, well, what do you say?
I can't think. Can't add Sandra because she has no microphone.
Sandra has no mic.
Could add Ricky there, because he said he wanted to join earlier.
I guess so.
If Ricky's still there, that is.
Well, does Ricky know about the game, that is?
Well, on that too. But, we'll find out. Hang on.
Come on, I'm gonna go one bumpy. Oh, shit. Nearly got eaten. I nearly got eaten.
Got eaten?
Yeah, I fucking might. Wait, what? So right now we're wondering who else should we add?
Alright, I'm back.
Hello!
Who do you say we should add to the call, Vic? One person, though.
Ricky.
Does he not believe him, though?
I'm not sure. He might.
Well, hopefully.
If he doesn't end well, that's just... Well.
So I'm supposed to meet that bitch over here.
What bitch? Where?
No, it's not. It's some other bitch.
That's some other bitch.
I've got a research project going, and maybe I got a research project going. We're the ones on a
big quest here. Hello.
Hello. Well,
perhaps we can help. How much do you know about the precursor legacy?
Yeah. How much do you know
How
about
much do
the
you
Jak
know about
Daxter?
The precursor legacy?
Pretty much Jak and Daxter 1.
Oh, I don't remember any of it, but I finished Jak and Daxter 1 and 2.
Pretty much we're in the second area of this game.
Where everything is all to shit.
Oh, you guys are still streaming?
Yeah, we are.
I didn't expect you to add me.
Oh, we were saying, oh, we're gonna add one more person, so... Fair enough. You asked before, so, yeah. If Sandra was there,
all right,
then we could have added Sandra, but... I mean, if she had the microphone, my bad.
What's this? Oh, wait a minute. Crazy said, I always wanted to be an added to a stream as a new guest, but unlike some people, I don't get pissed when I'm not added.
Who is
that? Those are strange people. Oh, wait a minute, oh, well, those strange people. Why the fuck did you add me, motherfucker? Just kidding.
Oh, yeah, Crazy Carrie, it always asks me if she could be added and, like...
You mean, like, freaking Riley?
Yeah, well, Riley's a prick, so...
Riley, like, DDoS, some bullshit.
Added Mike Pollock? Who the fuck's Mike Pollock?
Mike Pollock is Eggman, Meat from Ultimate Muscle, the Pokemon announcer.
Actually, is he actually online? Maybe we can add him. Oh my god, Victor!
Yes.
Victor, oh, sorry, I forgot the fucking mute.
I don't want to hear you slurping on your dick.
Shut up, I already know!
Wait, yes. So, did you just say you already know that you're slurping on dick?
No! I already know I'm fucking slurping on the noodles, like...
Anyway,
I hit the mute button, but it unmuted.
Victor, kill yourself. Anyway, yes. He's online.
You should add him here.
I don't know if he'll join.
Add him and see what happens. Like, hey, okay, we're live streaming and shit. Let's see... Oh shit, I nearly died. God, this game is so difficult. Like, there are certain things that it's... difficult to get to. What the fuck is that? Hang in there, little ones. Oh my god, I really hate it whenever you get hit by something in this game. It's like so fucking annoying. Write to him in the chat that like we're live streaming Jak and Daxter, and like if you'd like to join the commentary, that'll be kind of funny. How is that possible? This is literally nearly impossible. Yes, I did it! Woohoo! I don't have any other method to do this. This is like the only method that I know to do this shit. Good luck, boys! Boy! Wait, what? Yeah, boy! Well, the call has gone silent as fuck.
There are
I just brought crisp with me and I'm hungry, so I might have to meet the mic.
What? You brought Spyro Jam with you?
No! Skips!
Skrit? What?
No, skips!
Skrits? What?
I'm just kidding.
Hey, do your game.
Isn't that supposed to be some kind of a stage thing? Why is he wearing that thing around him?
I really like the first two Jak and Daxter games.
I only like the first.
Fuck you then.
I'm gonna go cry in a corner.
Okay.
Oh my god. This game is long as fuck.
Sorry, like, damn, I just hit the... Okay, seriously.
Ow.
I've got a problem with this mouse. Okay. Every time I click something, it clicks twice, so when I hit mute, it unmuted me.
Lol.
Like, and I'm trying to mute so I can fucking eat my noodles.
Fucking slurping on dick.
Well.
Alright.
Kindly remove your brain. Thank you.
What? Brain.
Kindly remove your own brain. Thank you.
What brain?
Can they actually get up there without... Can I actually get there, like, get up here, like, without getting that bike or whatever?
Victor, you don't have a brain.
I'm gonna try and do this.
Yeah, I just have two screws that won't freaking go around each other.
What?
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 Oh, fuck, I nearly did it.
We did it. We did it. We did it. Hooray!
Fuck, it's like impossible to get up there. And I have no idea how to activate this bike or whatever. I literally forgot nearly everything about this game.
Going around the corner for my mom. I'll be back in just a few minutes.
Oh, great.
Not feeling peckish anymore, so it's good.
Alright, what are you doing? To this guy.
Oh, my achy.
One of your vital organs. Walk it off, tough guy.
Oh, sure, I was tough once. Maybe even the toughest of them all. I single-handedly defended.
I don't think you're supposed to get up the wall like that, Danny.
Almost a year. I know.
Then that horrible monster.
It didn't hurt to try.
Against the boulder bombardment. So.
It's like sniffing its own valor, fucking
armor shining in the sun. I climbed the hill to take him on. But he pounded me like one tenderizes a Yakow steak.
Have you tried attacking him with your melodrama? Cause it's killing me!
After my last freaking
Daxter is such a prick.
He sealed the I know, right? I mean, I like his species, but I don't like his fucking attitude. It's like, holy fucking shit, what is wrong with you?
Well, that's what makes the game interesting. Our sage,
a master. He's a pretty cool
Daxter,
guy.
You're gonna fucking get.
Daxter is a cool guy, Danny.
He's a cool guy. He makes fun of people and isn't afraid of anything.
I kinda like freaking Kazooie better. I mean, yeah, she's a bitch, but at least she's not afraid of fucking
Kazooie.
Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie? Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie. At least
I
was able to pull enough. I mean, she's a bitch, but fucking hell.
I don't think Kazooie's a girl, though.
Oh, no, they say he's a girl. They say I see Kazooie's a girl. We're gonna need you to
put him back and stuff. Banjo the pimp.
Banjo the pimp, yeah. Oh yeah, let's not forget frigging, what you call it, Encyclopedia Dramatica. They made a fucking picture of Banjo fucking Kazooie, and Kazooie's just collecting money like a fucking gold digging whore.
Viggy. Language.
Oh my god.
Trust me, Danny, this
bitch,
worse.
This bitch again asked me, like, oh, bring 90 precursor orbs. Fucking asshole, what's up with like all of these idiots asking for 90?
Jack doesn't talk in this game because the game is good. You know the game is bad when Jack starts talking. That is why Jack does not talk.
Oh shit, I nearly died. You can literally, when you're about to get eaten by that fish, or whatever, like, you know that it's there. But I don't have 90 of those things. How the fuck am I supposed to get 90 of these things? Of the precursor orbs? When I really have nowhere to go to. It's kind of weird. Like, the bike is not, that freaking machine is not over there. So I cannot really go over there, yet I think I did something wrong.
Whoopsie.
Yep.
Sandra says, I love character Daxter. My feet hurt.
Interesting.
I gotta love Sandra. I'm actually getting kinda tired, if you're
asking. Aww. Slippy!
I hope you know you're nowhere near the end of this game, so if you're trying to do that, you're gonna be here for about, like, 6 more hours.
Yeah. 100%ing this game is a mess.
Yeah.
Actually, more like, you're only in like the second world. Or like, the second area. Like, you're gonna be here for like another million hours. Because the game is long.
I'm gonna do it by parts. Yeah, people, the stream is actually gonna go by parts, by the way. because I really do not think that I'm gonna stay up this long.
I'll be in just a little bit longer. I haven't left yet. Brother's not ready.
His brother's not ready.
Not ready to what? Not ready.
He's not ready to come with me.
You.
Speaking of which, on your stream, you just got 69 precursor eggs, right as I said that.
Oh, you asshole! Oh, you fucking asshole, I just died!
Damn!
Don't
why
look towards the light,
Jack! If you'll see that, like, the way he dies, it looks like whenever in Vice City, whenever he gets hit, there's a certain animation that it looks exactly the same as in Vice City. You'll notice that in a minute, Victor, in the stream. Kind of strange, but yeah, it's kind of, yeah. By the way, people, I might do a continuation of the stream tomorrow, just in early time because I've got work. It's gonna be, let's say right now, it's what, 11:44?
Man, his eyes are so pixelated.
Yeah.
Pixelated.
Not pixie.
I just feel like saying pixie for giggle.
You fucking want mine?
Another thing I like about this game is, like, I know it's made by Naughty Dog, but I like how they're so lazy that they just copy-pasted Crash Bandicoot's attack animation.
I mentioned that earlier, like, everything is Crash, literally.
Crash Bandicoot!
Like, spin attack, body slam, double jump, all of that shit is in here.
And, well, Jack can actually
But Crash
swim.
Bandicoot...
Yeah,
but
Jack can Crash... swim, there's the difference, he can
But
swim
Victor, and... Crash Bandicoot never drove a car.
Oh no, oh, that happened so many times in Jack already.
Oh wait, yes he did drive a car, never mind. It was a go-kart, but same thing.
He drove a car too, Crash Tag Team Racing.
I just said that.
No, I mean not kart, I said car, like an actual car. You said kart.
Oh wait,
man, he actually drove cars too.
What is this thing? There is this thing that electrocutes you if you get near it, and it looks exactly like the thing from Crash Bandicoot 1. It's in
oh,
the
died.
One stage.
Died.
Yeah, I die like a billion times in this fucking game. I just got fucking hit and I fell down. Weesh! I'm pretty bad in this game. With this game, sorry. I'm kind of rusty with this game because like I haven't played
At
it in such
game.
A long time and go fuck yourself.
I don't know.
It's like just spinning instead of hitting the button.
I don't feel like it. Maybe later.
What? Because of you I fucking
fuck.
Die, you bitch.
You tell me.
Puta madre.
Wow, that is very Grand Theft Auto-ish.
You told me to go fuck myself. I said I'll do it later.
Oh!
Oh shit, nearly died. That was so close. What the fuck is that anyway? It's just puffing up like a fucking weirdo.
I like how this game looks exactly like Twin Sanity 2.
I like how its run animation is similar to Mind Over Mutant's run animation.
Ew! No, I don't like this
it's
game
anymore.
It's
true as well!
I don't like this game at all.
Oh.
Oh, you still love it. Jack 1 is the best Jack game.
No, my number one. Simply the best!
No, it wasn't. It's okay, game people. It's Ricky just trolling, so.
Oh, he's gonna die.
No, actually, in my opinion, I don't like it.
Well, good for you. Nobody likes your opinion.
I don't give a shit.
People, don't you agree with me? His opinion is wrong.
And then it'll be like,
I never got that. It's fucking stupid. Your opinion is wrong. What? It's an opinion.
It's an opinion, bitch. Get over it.
Well, his opinion is wrong. Oh,
well, there's
shit.
Those freaking
pipes that are like so Crash Bandicoot Kudish as well. The ones that are hot.
Yeah. So that's like, what I mentioned. No, they're electrocuting. Well,
yeah,
this is Crash Bandicoot 2. We're literally in the stage of Crash Bandicoot 2.
Oh, I remember this bit with the platforming spinning around. It's like Spyro, only except Jack did that first.
I fucking hate this part. Like, this challenge over here, this place over here, is one of the, like, my most hated areas in the fucking game. It kind of, like, this stage makes you feel like, oh my god, this place is gonna take me fucking hours to complete. That's the vibe that I'm getting from it.
The vibe, baby. And do it for the vibe!
And pretty much you have to do this shit.
I don't care what nobody says, that fly looking thing looks like a cow.
Whoa! Fly thing.
It looks like a moo-moo fly thingy.
The fuck is a moo-moo fly thing?
The moo-moo fly, wait, what?
The fuck's a moo-moo fly? I
don't know, yeah, I just made up the term.
Moo-moo fly, let's see if it exists. Moo-moo fly.
Well, Vicky seems aroused.
No, it says moon at the moo at the moon. Moo moos keep calm and love moo cow.
What?
Fly air moon.
What about Smoogie? I'm just kidding. Oh well, there's a moo fly. What the fuck is that? A Pokemon?
Yeah, it's a fucking Pokemon.
Moo fly, moo fly.
I love how they put, whenever you fail in some things, like, they put, like, this music, like, dun, dun, or some shit, like, why?
Are you having a fucking funeral?
It seems like it with this game.
Crash Defano says, sounds good. I'll just have bread and tomatoes.
What?
Then he says, sewer or later. And Andres says, a moo-moo cow, LOL.
What?
It's just like moo-moo cow and moo-moo chan and moo-moo town with moo-moo hicks.
What about Momo Chow? Hey guys, it's Ren Ren Chow.
What about Omni Chow?
What? Who's a chav? Well, Victor.
You won't, mate!
Press B to do a somersault!
Wait, what?
What? What about asshole assault?
DJ assault.
Oh, look, now I'm in the mood to listen to Baymax.
Jump out a window!
Big titty bitches, you know where it's at.
Noi yoi!
Still can find that. Noi yoi. That's a new one.
I nearly failed. Yeah, we did it! We did it!
It sounded like a fucking mouse, man. Like,
alright, we got 29 power crystals, whatever.
Power Rangers. That's what Bob does in my head.
What?
29 power
Rangers. Watch Super Mega for the final result. I'm
shut up.
Fuck off. I want to hear about fucking Power Rejects.
Hey, I wasn't the one who mentioned it.
Yeah, Ricky!
I said I wouldn't do much talk to you about that.
It's only because Victor said it.
I didn't say Power Rejects! What the fuck?
Ricky,
we're talking about Moo-Moo Cows over here. How do we get to that?
Why, like, whenever Jack is, like, doing a certain, like, he does this thing where it looks like he's in Mortal Kombat or some shit. You'll see in a second.
When he stops or some shit?
Yeah, whenever he stands, it's like, it does like a Mortal Kombat, like, I'm ready to attack it. Alright, we're getting the third one!
It kind of reminds me of Liu Kang for some. Oh shit! You almost fell and I felt the pressure.
Oh shit!
And I fucked up.
Fuck yeah!
What was that?
That was loud. Maybe I need to turn down my microphone, so.
No, I need to turn down my Skype because it's on 100.
Hey, motherfuck!
Yeah.
Oh my god, I hate when this thing is like stuck like your mother is fucking dying in a fucking.
Damn! Calm down, Daniel, calm down!
He just nosedived into a completely different topic.
Fucking cunt.
Stop it, Daniel, just calm the fuck down!
I played Sonic CD yesterday!
Well,
wow, who?
I'm so sorry for you.
What?
I'm crying in the corner. Nigga, that's kawaii.
That's Noah's job.
No, Noah's job. Noah's job is to just pop from the corner.
What about
Noah's job?
I said Noah's job, not Noah's
Noah Toasty Blask.
What?
You know, like Dan Toasty Forden? The guy that
what?
Popped?
What? Who's Dante Forsky?
What about
Dan Toasty Forden? He's the guy who pops out of the corner and says, Toasty!
Oh,
said
like
Noah Toasty Blask.
I said something about the foreskin. That's what I heard. if you people want to hear more about foreskins, Victor Cotillion or at IGN.
I don't like IG.
Victor's an expert on foreskins.
What? Victor's your ex-girlfriend? What?
What?
Ah, fuck. Oh, you fucking cunt, dick sucking cunt.
It's the Moomoo cow right there.
Moomoo cow!
Is that a Moomoo cow? Yay, it's a Moomoo cow fly thingy.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
Moomoo cow fly thing.
What the fuck?
That's what it looks like. I don't know what the fuck
what?
Is. Moon. Cats!
Oh,
Moomoo
yeah!
Moomoo cow sounds like the name of a sexy cowgirl.
Oh, what a cute dragon thing!
Yeah, Moomoo Chad, my character. I'm making a character called.
Make sure to unsubscribe to Crash Legends 25 for that shameless plug.
Oh my god!
Oh my god, that's some funky shit!
Please subscribe to Loud Bandicoot 93. Shut up! Oh, that is a joke.
I like the guys.
Oh! That water is like Crash Bandicoot.
I wonder
like
how many times I've died in here. By the way, people, today I've recorded some. One Crash Bash part. And, well, I thought I was. At first, I thought I was recording one.
What the fuck is that?
And then I recorded the wrong part.
Der.
Wait, does like Daxter even make smart-ass comments when you fucking die in the other games? I forgot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Does he just fall to the ground and Daxter doesn't say anything?
What shit?
It just reminds me of like Smokey from Friday when he's.
You guys so many times.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm
rusty
pretty bad
at this game.
Yeah, I'm not that good with this game, really.
With yourself.
What the fuck is this?
Well, at least you're not as bad as Victor when he's playing Sonic games.
No, I'm not as bad as Victor is when he's playing Solitaire.
I get hit every 5 seconds when I'm playing Solitaire.
By the way, people, Victor cannot play Solitaire for shit.
Yeah, I can't. I fucking suck. I'm practically retarded at that.
Not practically, you are.
I am retarded at that. Nice shut me down, you prick.
Shaking you down.
Shake the motherfucker.
It's okay. It's okay, Victor. I'm always here for you.
Oh.
Am I even going in the right place?
I don't
probably
know.
Probably not. If you still need to get.
Enemy.
If you still need to get those 90 eggs, though, you have them now.
90 eggs? Look at the animation of his death. It looks like it's in Vice City or some shit. It's fucking weird. By the
Wasted.
Way, any new comments?
There's a lot. We've been reading them as they come.
Yeah, I just haven't been sending it out loud because I'm not Noah.
Alright, read them.
Maybe fucking it is Ricky, because I've been on the dark side of the internet for too long, says Crazy Kari. And Crazy Kari also says, how did you record the wrong part? Crazy Kari says, I would die a lot in this game too. Then Andres or Alano, I guess he's like talking about the situation, what Ricky just did and what I just said. It's like, poor Victor.
What did I do? I don't pay attention.
No, the shutting down thing that you just did, my response.
Oh,
that's
my
what
God.
He's talking about. It's kind of delayed, so yeah, not too delayed, but just a little.
I'm keep on dying on like the exact same
door. Does Sandra still go to the Church of Fudge?
Yes, she does. And she loves it.
I thought she went to the speed run of nuns wearing sunglasses.
Nuns wearing sunglasses? That's a new one.
It's old. It's in that picture with all the...
which shades? What?
Wow, that is a very Jak and Dax. No, I mean, not Jak and Dax. It's GTA like death.
In Vice City.
Yeah.
And this is like Spyro or some shit. This thing. Now we've got another precursor orb, I think.
Look for carvings in the wall. You will find one of Ass Bandicoot.
Shut up.
I'm being serious.
And I died. What the fuck?
You did!
You'll see the death animation that just happened a second ago. It's fucking weird. You fucking cunt, you dick sucking cock licking ass. Bitch, cunt.
Billy, calm.
Keep that up and I think you'll swear more than my fucking shitty parodies will. Oh god, he died again.
Oh,
wow, it's
god.
Like he's become, like, becomes nothing. Wow. You're dying left and right, man. Get it together.
My god! Fuck off! I know I'm dying left and right, for fuck's sake. It's not.
How
me.
Do you die on... That was a weird death.
It's a weird death. Ah, electrocuted!
It's like, it's difficult to hit the enemies.
That enemy is so big, and when it puffs like that, it gets right in front of the fucking screen, so you can't.
I'm so sexual, Victor. Why you gotta be so.
When it
sexual.
Puffs like that, like a puffer fish.
Like a puffer dick, for fuck's sake!
I kinda like that creature that puffs up like a fucking.
Sandra just said, Victor, shut up.
I agree.
Why? Because I mentioned, like, the Church of Accomplished Sunglasses? I'm just.
By the way, Danny, when you roll and jump, you go far.
Wait, glitch! What the fuck?
He knows that.
You got a glitch, dude! Like, you fucking died in the water, like...
Yeah,
you were standing on land and what the fuck?
Doesn't
fucking glitch magnet?
Hey, I got the glitch, and I'm gonna upload a video about it.
Okay, be right back!
What the fuck?
What?
It's like, okay, be right back. What the fuck?
I guess?
Oh shit! Oh god. Okay, I'm nearly dead. But gladly I'm not.
Uh-huh.
And I missed it. And I'm gonna kill myself. There we go. And keep away from those dark I'm trying to like get all the precursor orbs or whatever, eggs. Where's the egg?
Where's the egg?
Where's the Kinder eggs?
We both said like where's the egg
Jinx.
At the same time. Or jinkies.
Jinkies! Fucking jinkies shit!
Watch. Hey. Sandra, watch your language.
Did you say that your mother is a watch?
No, I said watch your language, Sandra. Sandra? No, Vicky.
What?
Hey, Danny, do you want to drink a Scruples?
What?
Scruples.
I thought you said purple nurples.
What about this
Scruples.
Stripping pole or whatever?
Scruples.
What the fuck is that?
Scruples.
What the fuck is that?
It's a drink.
What kind of drink?
Is it jizz that you drink every day in the morning?
It's a ginger ale.
It's a ginger egg. Yep. What?
Yeah, it's a Kinder egg.
Where am I going to?
Up your butt.
I like don't even know where I'm going to.
Up your butt.
Say what butt in the butt. Vicky, what's a bubba bee in the butt?
Wow, you raised a piece of
shit. I hit pause by mistake.
Oh, did they actually unban Kinder eggs?
In England they still do Kinder eggs, yeah.
Not you.
But now they have.
Talking about America.
Well, maybe.
America is special.
Is a special. And
America is special because fat kids choked on them and they got banned.
Fat fucks.
Well.
Fat cunts. That's not your cake, you fat cunt.
Not your fault.
Not your fault. I fucking love that.
If Victor would learn to chew his food, maybe we could have nice things in this country.
What? Right, so he chews his food from his ass or some shit? What the fuck?
And he pukes from his mouth.
Victor's fat and he's the reason Kinder Eggs got banned.
That would be a weird thing. It's just Victor's just this morbidly obese kid.
He is morbidly obese. You have to roll. Jump.
The roll technique is always good.
And now I'm gonna return underwater. Max, I'm gonna blow your face. We're gonna go underwater.
What, Kai? What?
I haven't heard that in
forever.
Max, I'm gonna blow in your face. We're gonna go underwater.
That doesn't even make sense. Why would you blow in someone's face?
I don't know. That's what that fucking woman in the video says. Goes, you're gonna blow in your face, and then we're gonna go into water.
You live in Eggland. Why would you blow in someone's face?
Eggland.
I don't know. Why the fuck anyone would blow anybody's face?
Died. Oh my god. By the way, people, I have a question. Would you like me to actually continue this stream tomorrow? Oh, for fuck's sake! I'm getting kind of tired over here. Even though I took a nap, but that nap did not really help much. I took a nap earlier, and we're literally like, what, two hours in? Wait, how long are we into the stream, Vicky?
About like 2 hours.
2 hours, 1 minute, and 30 seconds.
Jesus Christ. So, people, what do you say? Do you think we should, yeah, take a break and, continue the stream tomorrow. But of course, as I said, like, I have to do this earlier than, you know, and I fucking died. Isn't that great? It's just wonderful.
Oh, yes.
I'm literally about to fall asleep, my friends, and I fucking got hit as soon as I jumped into the motherfucking fuck me some fucking cunt water, sorry.
Billy! What have I told you to calm the fuck now?
The health system is just god awful in this fucking game. It's fucking terrible. There we go, I just fucking died, and he's doing this fucking Vice City animation. But either way,
wasted.
Any new comments, by the way?
Let's see.
It's fine if you continue the stream tomorrow. I got to go to school in 20 minutes anyway, though I'm going to the zoo with my boyfriend tomorrow, so I won't be able to watch it live. Hey, that's ironic, because I'm going to the zoo in February with mine.
Ah, fuck. So, who goes to school on Friday?
Everybody on the planet.
Yeah, I did before.
But is it like 2 p.m. over there?
I don't know where this crazy Kari person lives.
She lives in the U.S.
America, I think. Yeah.
Wait, what? What? You go to school in 20 minutes? Wait, it's probably college.
Yeah.
Most likely.
Can you actually slow down in this shit? This is so
sliding.
This is so fresh to insanity. The whole sliding.
If you hit the yellow boxes, do you get take damage?
Yeah.
Yes, he does. I've seen him die by that.
Oh, you do.
Which I did before a minute ago.
And died.
A lot of times.
And you just did.
And I fucking died again. That's right. Piece of shit. I'm sorry, this is my way to get my anger out. Fucking shit.
I know.
Challenge. It's like so easy to die. Why did they not think of this? Not even you fucking retards.
Why not you just pull back? You know, like make yourself slow down by pulling back on the analog stick or something. Maybe that would work.
I don't think that helps really. No, it doesn't.
It helps in some games. Help in some games.
In this one, it doesn't.
Which sucks, epic ass.
In here, you're sliding as fast as shooting cum in your mother's eye. No, I'm just kidding.
This person says, bruh. Bruh, I didn't say I was going to school. I'm going to a church party that my mom is forcing me to go to. I said nothing about school. I assumed. Say hi to Noah Blask and Sandra Cox when you see them.
Yeah, Crazy Carrie's right. She didn't say anything about a frigging school.
I assumed.
You assumed, yeah.
How the fuck do you get back up there? You dicks! Oh my god.
Dick!
Dick! You really did that? You were like right by the egg and you hit the box when you already were off the sled. But why?
So you can get the... Trying to get that up there.
Oh my god, I cannot do this. My god, I died again. For fuck's sake. But either way,
I don't think you're supposed to go back up the ramp.
I don't fucking know, but either way, people, we're gonna continue the stream tomorrow. I'm just extremely exhausted. I wish I had more energy, but I feel like shooting myself in the head right now. So tomorrow around, let's say, what would be 7 p.m. your time? Well, it's like 7 p.m. my time, but what would be in your time, people? Because I'm not too sure if people will be up by then.
Nope.
Okay, people, what's the time for you right now? I would like to know. I'm going to continue.
10 past 10.
Well, not in the UK. The UK is easier to know, but America is just fucking all over the place. I mean, you already know how America... Wow, this is really crashed to insanity when it comes to think of it. There's so many similarities to Twinsanity. Remember that there is this chase thingy in Crash to Insanity, where you have to run to the side, like around this place, in order to reach up at the top.
I think so. I can't say I fully recall because I haven't played it in ages.
Whee! At least we're getting this part done.
Yeah, that does look exactly like Queen Sanity.
Queen Sanity.
Except you're not rolling like a retard. You're not rolling like a retard.
Yeah.
So it's easy.
The fuck? Anyways, any new comments? By the way?
What, Kai? What's the matter with you?
Oh, the call has gone shit quality for some weird reason.
Stone Trooper says 5:11 p.m. Crazy Kari says in Florida it's 5:11. 5:11 Tennessee, 4:11.
5:11?
It's actually
like 4:11.
PM.
AM?
P.M.
Then fucking say P.M., bitch!
I did.
He did.
Say
he did.
A.M. or P.M. That's what I fucking understand.
You're lagging.
You're shagging.
I heard him. No, but seriously, I heard Ricky said P.M.
I didn't hear him. I heard A.M. So.
I didn't say.
If it's 5 p.m., maybe around 1 to 2 p.m. your time.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Yeah.
Yeah. So pretty much around that time, tomorrow, because I have to get to work like the day after. So I'm gonna be
basically like it's 12 a.m. for people who live in California. It's 1 a.m. for Central Time, and it is 2 p.m. for those who live in Florida.
Yeah.
And around Florida.
So if people will be here, you'll know it like Florida, you know, time zone. like what time the stream is gonna begin. So I'm gonna actually name this part of this stream like part one. So like tomorrow, like there will be part two. And hopefully by then we can finish this whole game. It's just that I'm extremely exhausted.
I don't think you'll finish it tomorrow. Again, you're just at the beginning of the game. This game's like 12 hours long.
Thank fuck! I collected everything and I died right after. Fuck. And I'm at the exact same spot! I'm pretty much at the exact same part I was a minute ago. But at least we've got everything. That's the important thing. For some reason, this is the music reminds me of Crash Bandicoot.
Because it's Naughty Dog?
Because it's Naughty Shut the Fuck Up. No, I'm just kidding. Naughty Dog Goo!
Fuck you. Ew.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Nah, you're such a dog!
Fuck you.
Why, like, can I jump any higher? I hate
I
the jumping, it's so slow.
Yes.
You get a double jump later in the game.
You already have a double. Dumble jump?
A dumble jumple.
You already have a double jump, though.
Oh, well, then you've already reached a point where you get
it. Ricky, shut the fuck. What the fuck was that?
That's what I like to know. I was like, eh!
Oh my god, shut up.
Do it again.
Do it again. Do it again.
Okay.
Do it again. Do it again. Don't you know that song? That song is by Fatboy Slim. We're actually gonna get back to the mainland and then I'm gonna stop streaming. Because that's
what?
The main place.
He's okay. I don't know whether you started streaming too early or too late, to be honest. That's what Cool Pro said.
Yeah,
sorry.
I started streaming very late. I think I should stream a little earlier. Then what the fuck just happened there? That enemy just came out of nowhere. Wait, what am I doing? There is no need to return back to that area. Ah, that's stupid.
Derp.
I could have returned to this place. Do I even sound like Daxter?
Hey.
I probably don't. Fucking enemies. And I died. This is gripe, people. I just fucking died again.
Derp.
I hate those these enemies that are just spinning in fucking circles.
What do those green orbs do again?
Take a shit. I mean, they do stuff. I don't know.
Well,
they get your health back, pretty much.
Ah, okay. You need 100 of them then?
No, 50.
Gay. That's too many.
No, it's not. Well, yeah, it is. It's like it take me. It took me like a to get a second thought. Any new comments, by the way?
Listen.
I love how Charles Zimbilla
Charles
made the models.
Zimbilis.
Zimbilis.
Made the models for this game.
Made
Wrath.
The models for this game, Wrath and Nitro Kart.
Yes, yes.
Well, sadly, sadly, he didn't get credited like that, which is sad. Not that we're pricks towards him. Even Josh Mansell, the person who originally created the music from Crash Bandicoot, they did not credit him in some of the stuff. He never gave permission to remix. Like in Crash Bash, for example. In Crash Bash, Josh Mansell was not really the person who made the music. Or even in Wrath of Cortex. But of course they did not give any kind of credit to why did Crash's like theme sound like the way it did.
Cool Porn says, I would personally start streaming from at least 3, 4, or 5 p.m. at the earliest, but that's just me. Cool Porn, he
it
has
depends.
Some work.
Like, you brought me the priest. Americans get on right. Very late for people bridge. From Israel
don't
in
ask me
the
to
UK,
that creature
which is
again.
It's a really big problem, really, because the time difference is just awful. It really is. What the fuck? Daxter is like doing the fucking. Is like dancing or some shit. Do I have 90 orbs? Yes, I do. Yahoo!
Whoa, yeah! These orbs will help me win my way back out of this barrel. Here's the power cell, I promise.
So we've got 2 power cells right now since we've got enough orbs. And we're technically down to 97 thingies, whatever they're called. Isn't what is it called? Banjo-Kazooie, there is something called Jiggies or whatever.
Yeah, that's the main collectible of the game. It's the jigsaw puzzles.
I cannot even fucking speak. Isn't the thing that reminds you of Crash Bandicoot?
No. What?
Fuck you.
What reminds you of Crash Bandicoot?
My dick. No, I'm just kidding.
I don't think that reminds me of Crash Bandicoot.
That was a weird ass laugh. But either way, people, in the next part, in the next stream, to be honest, we will be reaching to another area. Hopefully, we'll be able to finish the game tomorrow. But,
nope.
It depends on how early. Oh, I don't have to take the dog out for a walk tomorrow, so that's a good thing. But either way, people, I cannot even speak. Either way, thanks for watching, people. I really hope you enjoyed the stream, and I will see you tomorrow at the second part of the stream. If it's not going to end tomorrow, then there's going to be a third part, which is probably going to be on Sunday if I'm not going to be tired from work. That is, which I'm most possibly going to be extremely tired. But either way, thanks for watching, everybody. I really hope you all have enjoyed the stream, because I personally did. I wish I was not as tired as I am, but I'm just like super exhausted right now. It's unreal. And I just farted, sorry. and pretty much we might do a Crash Let's Play Live thingy later on. And it's actually raining here right now in Israel, surprising me. But yeah. thank you all for watching the stream. I really hope you all enjoyed it. I will also will try to make this a little bit more alive than usual. And I might start doing more streams on Twitch. It really depends, but you can follow my Twitch. It's the link is actually in the description of the video. Excuse me. So you
it's
can
actually not.
It is. Or you can
donation
go to my
link.
Channel.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
Yeah, pretty much. You can go there and like follow me on Twitch, and I might be doing some stuff over there. But as for now, thanks for watching, everybody, and I will see you tomorrow. Goodbye.
Bye.